From the studios of Adventist World Radio.
Hello and welcome.
This is the International English Service from Pune.
Today in our program, we have music coming to you from Family Reunion Concert Singers and Jody Malashenko.
A health message on chronic obstructive pulmonary disease.
Our thought for the day is taken from God's word on the topic, I will help thee. I am Gladys.
I am Sharad.
And you are listening to Adventist World Radio, the voice of hope.
To begin, here's a song entitled, Satisfied.
Well, satisfied with Jesus. Said He would be my comfort. And He said He would be my guide. Well, I looked at my hands. My hands were new. I looked at my feet and they did too. Ever since that wonderful day, my soul's been satisfied.
So satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus.
Oh, satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus. Say He would be my comfort. Say He would be my guide. Well, I looked at my hands. My hands were new. I looked at my feet and they did too. Ever since that wonderful day, my soul's been satisfied.
In mysterious ways, there's wonders to perform. You know He plants His feet on every step, and then He rides on every storm.
Well, He fixed my feet for running, left my eyes open and wide. Fixed my tongue so I could say, praise God, I'm satisfied.
So satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus.
So satisfied.
Satisfied. Said He would be my guide. Well, I looked at my hands looked new. I looked at my feet and they did too. Ever since that wonderful day, my soul's been satisfied.
Well, it was way down yonder in the valley, boys, I was wandering all alone. And it was there I met my Jesus. Well, you know He claimed me for His own. And then He put His arms all around me there, and He drew me up to His side.
Oh, yes, I'm satisfied.
I'm satisfied.
Satisfied with Jesus.
Hey, I'm satisfied. Now, Lord, let me tell you,
said He would be my comfort. My hands looked new. I looked at my feet and made it true. Ever since that wonderful day, my soul's been satisfied.
Satisfied,
satisfied with Jesus.
Satisfied,
satisfied with Jesus. Said He would be my comfort. Said He would be my guide. Well, I looked at my hands. My hands looked new. I looked at my feet and they did too.
You've been listening to a song by Family Reunion Concert Singers.
And now we bring a health message presented by Dr. Kisku on chronic obstructive pulmonary disease.
Our health talk today is about a common condition called chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Now, this is a problem that is increasing all over the world, affecting millions of people around the world. And it is the fourth most common cause of death worldwide. Chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, or COPD, includes emphysema and chronic bronchitis, which affects the lungs. I'll just review the basic physiology that goes on in the human body. Oxygen is vital for life. Without it, death occurs very rapidly. Now, the lungs allow us to fill our blood with oxygen. The air that we breathe comes in close contact with the blood in the depths of the lung. The blood then fills up with oxygen and releases unwanted carbon dioxide. When we breathe, the air goes in through our mouth and nose. From there, it goes into the air pipe known as trachea. From the trachea, it goes into smaller tubes known as bronchioles. And from there, it goes to small balloon-like sacs called the alveoli. On the other end of the alveoli, there are a small number of blood vessels that get filled up with oxygen and release carbon dioxide. COPD, chronic bronchitis and emphysema, are conditions that make breathing difficult. Frequent coughing and thick sputum may become very common. Wheezing also can occur. Patients have difficulty catching their breath. Even minimal physical exertions become very difficult to perform because of shortness of breath. Very often, many of these people need to carry portable oxygen that may be necessary for survival. Lung infections, known as pneumonias, become very frequent, and weight loss and depression may follow towards the end. What are the causes of COPD, or what causes COPD? The most important cause is active or passive smoking. Now, we all know about the ill effects of smoking. It causes heart attacks, it causes cancers, it causes various other types of cancer. But COPD is not often highlighted. And smoking is the single most important cause of COPD. Exposure to other irritants and pollution can also cause COPD. And there are a few genetic conditions that can also cause COPD. Now, severe lung infections can also cause COPD. Smoking, irritants, pollution, lung infection can cause inflammation of the bronchial tubes, the alveoli, and most of the cell lining inside the lungs. The inflammation causes thickening of the bronchial tubes and alveoli. This causes narrowing inside of these tubes and decrease in the capacity for the lungs to supply oxygen. The cilia of the lungs also are unable to expel the dirt accumulated in the lungs. And this causes further inflammation and infection that worsens the condition. And this vicious cycle is repeated. How is it diagnosed? After taking a detailed history and listening to the lungs, the physician usually asks for a test known as the pulmonary function test. This test aims at determining how your lungs are functioning. A chest X-ray also may be done, and specialized blood tests to check the levels of oxygen and carbon dioxide in your blood is also done. Now, the most important part of treatment in COPD is prevention. Prevention is always better than cure. Avoidance of smoking and smoke from others is essential in prevention. Avoiding other irritants and pollution is also important. Likewise, repairing lung damage is very difficult if the patient continues to be exposed to smoke or he keeps smoking. In cases of advanced lung damage, patients can take special measures to help decrease the symptoms. Inhalers are available, humidifiers are available, and there are some medicines called bronchodilators, which kind of open up the bronchi. Steroid medications can also decrease the inflammation and can relieve the symptoms. Chest physiotherapy may help in removing the sputum and expelling the dirt from the lungs. Antibiotics may be necessary to fight infections. However, eliminating exposure to smoke and to quit smoking is the most important therapy in COPD. COPD and emphysema are chronic lung conditions that could potentially be fatal. Significant advances in understanding and treating these diseases have been made in the recent years. The most important way people can decrease the risk of getting this disease is to stay away from smoking. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Kisku, for being on our program.
We are sure you've been benefited from this talk. To know more about our program, we invite you to write to us. Here's our mailing address.
Adventist World Radio, Post Box number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
Another song coming your way is by Jody Malashenko, entitled Holy Ground.
As I walk through the door, I sensed His presence, and I knew this was the place where love abounds. For this is the temple Jehovah God abides here. We are standing in His presence on holy ground. We are standing on holy ground, and I know that there are angels all around. Standing in His presence on holy ground. In His presence there is joy beyond measure, and at His feet peace of mind can still be found. If you have a need, I know He has the answer. Shout and claim it, child, you're standing on holy ground. We are standing on holy ground, and I know there are angels all around. Let us praise Jesus now. We are standing in His presence on holy ground. Let us praise Jesus now. We are standing in His presence. We are standing in His presence. We are standing in His presence on a holy ground. Holy ground.
For our meditation today, we have a message from God's Word on the topic, I Will Help Thee, brought to you by Pastor John Prasad Rao.
Dear listener, do you know that we so many times go to seek help elsewhere than where it is found? At this time, I read Isaiah 41:10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee, yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Therefore, with these thoughts, I would propose that there is help found only in God. Before we proceed, let's have a word of prayer. Loving Heavenly Father, we come to you as one in whom there is help, not only now, forever. As we seek help in you, we pray that you would lead us and guide us so that we might be able to receive the utmost for thy honor and glory, because we pray it in Jesus' name. Amen. Dear listener, the Bible is full of comforting, precious promises. It seems that for every human experience, there is some verse that fits every need. To single out one text and say, "This is my favorite, this has done me the most good, when my need is greatest, it comforts my soul most," is not easy. However, hundreds of times when my heart has cried to God in special need, He has brought to me the wonderful blessing and strength of Isaiah 41:10. A businesswoman once stopped at our house. She was soliciting. The day was very warm, so she sat down to rest and enjoy a cold drink. As we chatted about various things, the conversation turned to the Bible. She acknowledged the literary qualities of the Word of God. But when we mentioned prayer and its answers and expressed our confidence and faith in the promises of God, she frankly said, "I would give anything if I could believe in God and that He hears and answers prayer." The Christian has a happiness, a peace, and trust that I don't have. I have been reared without God and can't seem to find Him. To those of us who know God's truth and believe His word, what a blessing is ours. God says, "Fear thou not." Humanity fears. We have fears about our health, our profession, our business, our money, our property. We even fear that temptation might overcome us and that God will forsake us. We become filled with anxiety. But the comforting message says, "Fear thou not, for I am with thee." That is what makes the difference. I am with thee. Out in Africa, an old native woman accepted Christ. The change in her life was remarkable. Her trust was simple and absolute. Her heathen husband opposed her, and she was subjected to the most bitter persecution, even to the extent of beatings. Once the missionary said to her, "Don't you ever get discouraged? Don't you sometimes feel in your heart that you must give up?" "Oh no," she replied, "I belong to God. And when I am in great danger, I lift up my heart to the Lord and say, 'Master, this thy property is in grave danger. Come and take care of it.' And He does." God is ever present. His assuring word is, "I am with thee." Be not dismayed. Be not confounded, confused, or doubtful as to which way life's problems will turn out. Have you ever been a colporteur? Yes, you had weeks of success. There was a goal to be reached. Perhaps college seemed near, almost in sight. Perhaps it was a debt to be paid or a family to support. Then days passed and no success. Oh, how low your spirits dropped. The enemy was sweeping in. You were dismayed. You came to a green woods. No one was near. You fell on your knees and poured out your heart to the Lord of all. He answered, "Child of mine, be not dismayed. I am thy God. What of these trials? They have brought you to me. Now I want you to know that the words 'I am with thee' means not yesterday or tomorrow, but right now." You arose, The sunshine was brighter, and the whole world seemed radiant. You were conscious of a new blessing. At the next home, you took an order, and all day long, and in the weeks that followed, success came your way. Your goal was attained. Oh, what a promise! I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. In our physical as well as spiritual weakness, God strengthens. A young lady spent several hours each evening practicing on the church organ. Her parents cautioned her to leave the church by 9 o'clock always. One night she became so engrossed that she lost all sense of time. When she looked at her watch, it was 11. Quickly, she locked the church door and hurried down the street. A car drove up to the curb, and a heavy-breathed voice said, "Hello, beautiful, step into my car." She began to run. Her strength seemed to fail her. She reached the corner. No one was in sight. "Oh God," she cried, "strengthen me, help me." At once, her weakness became strength. She ran across the intersection where a plain, sweet, elderly woman took her arm, saying, "You are being followed, aren't you? I'll go with you." The car followed still. Finally, she and her companion turned in at her gate. At the door, she turned to invite in the one who had appeared at the very moment when she sorely needed help. Her kind companion was gone, without word or sound. Surely, God had sent an angel in human guise to give strength and help. "Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness." God's great right hand will hold us up and lead us. His arm is not shortened that it cannot save. His arm is not shortened that it cannot save. His stretched out arm has done wonders for his people from the days of old, not just for his people as a whole, but also for just one individual, even for you or for me. God is changeless. His love is beyond comprehension. His wooing spirit is whispering to his children, "Fear thou not, for I am with thee." Oh, that we might measure up to the stature that he expects of us, to be used by him as witnesses of his saving power and grace. The promise of Isaiah 41:10 is yours and it is mine. Let us pray. Loving Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for the promise of Isaiah 41:10. Help us to always remember and be enlightened and be encouraged so that we might be able to live for thee today and forevermore, because we pray it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor John Prasadara, for sharing God's word.
You are listening to the Voice of Hope from Pune, India.
Song of praise. Well, the blind are outside.
The Bible says, commit everything you do to the Lord. Trust Him and He will help you. Psalms 37:5. Friends, nothing is too small for God. When we commit our plans to the Lord, He commits Himself and His infinite resources to us.
With this, we come to the end of our program. You may wish to know more on God's Word. Therefore, we request you to write to us on
Adventist World Radio, Post Box Number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
Remember, our address is Adventist World Radio, Post Box Number 17, Pune 411001, Maharashtra, India.
You could also email us on amc3@vsnl.com.
That's amc3@vsnl.com. I'm Gladys.
And I'm Sharad, signing out from Adventist World Radio.
Do join us again along with your family and friends.
Until then, may you have good health and happy home. Goodbye and God bless you.